Today, we're getting in touch with our inner train conductor. Your number one job, basically, is just to keep the train on the tracks and avoid this. I'm Jeff, the radio DJ dude, and if there's any question, just please reference the shirt. As music conductors, our job is just to keep the songs flowing steadily, smoothly, one right after the other. Avoid train wrecks. And the particular radio wreck we're gonna be zooming into today is when you've got a sweeper or voice track element that just walks all over your song intro. Tramples the mood, ruins the moment. You'll wanna avoid that. Well, fear not, this radio DJ dude has got an easy fix that'll keep your radio train rocketing down the tracks. All aboard, let's check it out.
We are on the air.
Nothing sounds lower rent or small market jinky than automation gone awry. Extreme 80s fun right here on Triple X 80s. Hey there, my name is Jammin' Jeff Scott.
What are you looking at, butthead?
Only the sexiest 80s listeners. Thank you for cranking it up. It's Triple X 80s.
Oh my God, I'm so excited.
Oh, it's painful to listen to, especially when you hear a voice track murder the post of a song and the DJ doesn't respond, he just keeps talking. That's the biggest giveaway of an automated station. Not saying we have to trick everyone, but come on. The more effort we put in, the better the sound we put out. Maybe it's because of my broadcast roots or the fact I'm just a radio dinosaur that I love the sound of running elements, sweepers, voice tracks over song intros. To me, it just has that quote-unquote major market sound. And for listeners, it really keeps the momentum going. Instead of having to stop down and play an element, your audience is always hearing songs one right after the other. Here's the thing, we've read so many points of view on sweepers and song intros in the forum that I wanted to do a definitive test to finally get some real-world answers to how they work. And this is mainly an issue for people who use rotations to run their station, which I do. So checking out my rotations, you'll see that I have about 3 songs an hour that I run a sweeper over the intro. And I've done another video about how you could use sweepers as voice tracks. And it's a great way to solve the voice tracking issue within Radio DJ, so I urge you to check that out. But anytime you programmed a sweeper to play over the intro of a song, you've been given a number of options. Start, intro, and end. A sweeper at the start position is just like this. Triple X80s. Hey, I am Jammin' Jeff Scott. And just once your song starts playing, as does the sweeper, and Radio DJ will play whichever sweeper over the intro of that song, no matter the intro of that song, whether it's 3 seconds or 30 seconds. And if you have a 15-second sweeper, all Radio DJ knows to do is to play it at the start of the song, regardless of the intro. It ignores the intro data of the song. Now, I've come up with a rock-solid solution where none of my sweepers or production elements have ever stepped on the vocals of a song. Before we get to that, let's drill down a little deeper on the sweeper intro function. I think a lot of people are choosing this and getting a false sense of security that the software is going to perfectly select just the right sweeper for just the right intro. Let's test the theory and create a rotation where we attach a sweeper to the intro of a bunch of these songs that are in the pop mid category. And all that really means to you is they're songs that tend to have shorter intro times, which will make it more challenging for Radio DJ to select a sweeper of the right length. Okay, let's go. So we're gonna jump in the time machine, speed things up. For this test, we played about 28 songs with the sweepers set to the intro position. Out of that, 10 songs of those 28 were completely butchered by the sweeper or voice track. Triple X80s, and no need to go searching thrift stores or scrounging at the local dump to find all your favorite 80s music.
Seriously?
Yeah!
I'm so excited!
How did that go? That's what we like to hear on Triple X80s. Just wrecked. Al Jarreau, prepare to be trampled. You've got 12 seconds on your intro, where the voice track is 13. Only the lonely, not so lucky, 8 seconds. And let's take a look at the running time of that voice track, sweeper element. It comes in at 12 seconds. Let's do some quick math. 12 from 8. 28 played, 10 train wrecks. That's about 35%. But what does that mean? For you, the number could be higher or lower. It all depends on the songs that are in your library at that very minute. For this test, I chose to select songs based on least recently played. And if you look at my library, here are the pop mid songs. And if you compare them to what Auto DJ is selecting, it definitely tracks. It is selecting songs based on the play date. Least recently played are first up. And it doesn't appear that Radio DJ is selecting different songs within this library to fit. So the priority is to choose a song that's least recently played, and then hopefully search your sweeper library for one that fits. Now that's a total roll of the dice. As you see here, some of these intros just can't accommodate the sweepers because none of my sweepers are that short. And if I ended the video there, a great disservice would have been done. But no, I went back into the laboratory, set up some more tests to scratch an itch. The reason my initial test failed was because all my sweepers were over 13 seconds in my library. And I actually found this message from Marius in the forum. He even admits that Radio DJ will try to select a sweeper based on the intro of your song. Try being the key word. And the results are dependent on the variety of sweepers that are available to the program. Meaning if all your sweepers are over 12 seconds and you have a 5-second song intro, good luck finding a sweeper that's going to fit. So back to the drawing board. My next theory was, if you feed it a wide variety of sweeper lengths, maybe then it'll select the right sweeper for the right song intro. So we fire up Audacity and record a number of sweepers with varying lengths. We import those suckers into Radio DJ, change the sweeper category to our new test category, load up the rotation, and light the fuse. And then something very interesting happens. Radio DJ is delivering on the initial promise of this feature. As we see here in the playlist, it is choosing sweepers to fit over these song intros. Sure, some are a little short, these 2- and 3-second ones over long song intros, but at least the intros are not going to be trampled upon. So that's the Down and Dirty recap. Let's cut to some moments from the test to further belabor this point. This is interesting. We had Starship Sarah in our first test, and it failed to find the right sweeper to pair with a 9-second intro. This time, I'm impressed. It chooses a 3-second intro. Granted, we did have some 6 seconds in there. It could have maybe done a better job with that match, but at least it's not running all over the vocals. Okay, Michael McDonald on my own, 1-second intro. It's smart enough to say, I don't have anything to fit that. Next. Natalie Cole, 15 seconds. It gets a 6-second intro. Here's an example where sweeper intro falls short. Part of its functionality is running your sweeper right up to the intro point of your song. So if we had a 12-second sweeper here with Poison's 14-second song intro, that wouldn't sound bad. The song starts, plays for 2 seconds, and triggers a sweeper. This is a 6-second sweeper. By the nature of sweeper intro, Poison will play for 8 seconds before triggering the sweeper in order to hit the 14-second song intro. Ugh, that does not sound good in my book. Okay, here it is. It's counting down to 8 seconds before it starts the sweeper, and here we go. Totally awesome 80s music. There's only one spot for it, and oh my God, look at that. You're in it. It's Triple X80s. Well, that hit the post. It's just not very smooth. So let's make one more change in Auto DJ. Let's set this down to 5 seconds. So now Radio DJ will look at the song intro and say, if this is longer than 5 seconds, I'm going to play the sweeper at the start of the song, even if it has a sweeper intro setting. Let's clear our playlist. 80s test 1. Voice track test. Let's load this up and see what we get. Before we were set at 18, so look at Earth, Wind & Fire, 15, with a 6-second sweeper. Before, that would have played for 9 seconds before firing this off. Now, it's going to start right at the beginning of the track, and that's going to sound infinitely better. This is a 15-second sweeper, 20 seconds, plenty of time, 10 seconds over 17. That's great. Okay, this is mildly interesting. Now that all the sweepers have cycled through 1 or 2 times, you look at the date played. And if you remember, when we imported them, they're pretty much in the order of 2, 3, 4, and all up. But if you look at date played, you could see how Radio DJ is actually selecting sweepers to fit the song intro. Otherwise, if it were just playing them in the order last imported, then you'd see 2, 3, 6, 6, and then the others, which are 15 seconds. But it looks to actually be pulling the sweepers to fit the song intros. I don't know why this says 33 seconds. It's a 2-second sweeper. That's fascinating. Oh, wow. I didn't export just selected audio. I exported the whole thing. Hang on. Let's try this. Let's open up this cue point. Let us change this to like 20 seconds because we know we have song intros that are at least 20 seconds. So now it becomes a 19-second sweeper. So I wonder if it now will attach this to songs with 19-second intros and less. Let's figure that out. I think it loaded up a new song. Let's scroll down. Bobby Brown, Rock With You, 38 seconds. Look at that. It did attach the VT2 sweeper, which used to be 33 seconds. We cut it down to 19. It hadn't been played in a while. And the song's intro happened to be long enough to justify adding that sweeper. As more songs cycle through, some basic answers are becoming very clear. So here's what we know. My very unscientific conclusion is this. Using sweeper intro, Radio DJ looks to be selecting sweepers based on least recently played, until it hits the situation where you have a song with a shorter intro than your next sweeper. It'll skip the longer one and choose a sweeper with the same or shorter length of your song intro. But, and it's a big one, only if you have sweepers short enough in your library. Because when I first ran the test, all my sweepers were over 13 seconds. It just didn't have anything to choose from. I was setting it up to fail. Giving it shorter options, it definitely has come through. So part of my verdict is, yes, it's a solid option. You could probably sleep easy knowing your song intros won't get too battered by your sweepers and voice tracks. With the caveat, you have to have enough sweepers of varying lengths to make it interesting, to keep the variety fresh. If you only have 2 3-second sweepers, now those are going to get burned out pretty quick. The other thing we learned, for this to sound good, you have to change the sweeper settings. You can't say if the intro is longer than 20 seconds, play the sweeper at the track start. Because once again, you're in that same predicament with a 3-second sweeper, you're going to have 17 seconds of the song before it triggers a sweeper. That just does not sound good. Find a number that you could live with. I think 5 is a pretty good trade-off. As long as you follow those rules and you respect the parameters of sweeper intro, it could work perfectly for you. I needed more flexibility. And if you find yourself in the same boat where a lot of your sweepers are just long, you're not planning on cutting 50 new shorter sweepers to accommodate shorter song intros, then the solution I'm about to share will totally float your boat. So let's hook you up with that fix. And that fix actually starts with the music. So let's scroll down to this 80s classic. In the track edit window on the Others tab, this is where the song intro magic lives. So what are we looking at? I've set the mood to high. In a previous video, I showed you how to assign multiple categories and subcategories to your music. And one way is to use this language dropdown. I mean, geez, so many languages. I don't have many songs in Chamorro, but I sure have some ideas of what I could call a song that's linked to the Chamorro language. I use the language dropdown to assign years to every song. So for me, the 80s start in the B's. So Bambara is 80, 81, 82, 83, and so on. So Bahari, that's 1985. And you can reference that right here. But for song intros, the train wreck antidote lives on start type. Before I discovered the song intro hack, I never used start type. But infinitely more useful is using start type to indicate the length of the song intro. When I record my voice tracks, aka sweepers, I make sure that they're no more than 15 seconds. And as you can see, I've got a lot of sweepers, over 200. So if I know every one of those sweepers is 15 seconds or less, I can go into the database, drop some code, and say, hey, DB, I want you to give every song that has an intro of 16 seconds or less the start type called voice, which is start type 4 in the database. And with a little SQL magic, done. And as we can see, Tarzan Boy has an 18-second intro. Perfect. And if we stop by Maria's house, here we are in the database. And here's the code. What it's asking Maria to do is to update the following songs from the songs database. We want to set their start type to 4, which means voice, where the song type is music, has to be enabled. I've also added the ID genre is 143, which is top 40 for me. But you don't have to do that. You could just leave it as music and enabled. And queue times are not like 15, 14, 13, 0. So basically, every song in the database that fits these parameters will be set to start type 4 if there's 16 seconds or more. Pretty cool. So if we check this out, start type 4, apply the filter. So we see there's the ID genre 143, my top 40. And voila, start type 4. But come on, check my math. Don't believe some rando on YouTube. To check it, you have to look over here to the queue times column. This intro is 26, this intro is 17, this is 18, 19, 26, 17. So we're in good shape here. This did a wonderful job of adding the voice start type to all these songs that have an intro of 16 seconds or more. So when I'm programming songs with sweepers, or voice tracks, I first select sweeper to the start position, and then give it a voice start type. And now with those tweaks, every song that comes up in the rotation with a sweeper attached, it's going to fit. It's going to sound great. And oh, do I sleep like a baby.
So just like that, radio train wrecks, be gone. It's really that easy. I'm Jeff, the radio DJ dude. And worry not, all this jumbled code we were talking about, it's just right down here for your copying and pasting pleasure in the description box, but not quite as south of this video frame are two very important buttons. And I implore you to please give a click to the subscribe and like button. It'll cause severe giddiness and definitely help keep my little YouTube train on the tracks. Thank you so much, and most important, keep rocking those mics all over the world.